Welcome, everyone, to St. Luke's Lutheran Church and School. I am Pastor Wally Arp, and I'm the senior pastor here at St. Luke's. And once again, it's my privilege to introduce you to our St. Luke's concert series. We've been producing this concert series for well over 25 years now, but I'm absolutely confident this is the first time that we're attempting to do it all online in the context of a pandemic and all of the interesting circumstances that we're learning to live with and to deal with. Yet at the same time, we are excited to be able to offer the gift of music back to our community, something that we've had the privilege of doing through many of our very generous donors, and we're thankful for them and want to express that thanks to them through this introduction. I also always want to let you know that besides our concert series, there's lots of other activities that go on here at St. Luke's, including a whole range of Sunday morning worship services at 8, 9, 30, and 11, with various formats from traditional to contemporary to a children's service. We'd love to have you come check those out as well. Now, I hope you can sit back and enjoy this concert as we begin our new concert series here at St. Luke's.
Good evening and welcome once again to the St. Luke's concert series. My name is Nikki Peters and I'm part of the leadership team of our concert series. We're so excited to welcome tonight the UCF Symphony Orchestra, and they're here tonight because of all of the financial support and donations from all of you, not just over the last 26 years, but this year in particular when our fine arts programs and musicians are the most important and in the most need. If you're able to give a gift tonight, you can do so by going online to our website at slllcs.org/give, and you'll find a place to give a gift to our concert series. We're so excited that you're watching with us live online tonight, and I'd like to introduce to you the director of the UCF Symphony Orchestra, Dr. Chung Park.
I want to just say a few quick thank yous, most importantly to the concert series here at St. Luke's, and to Pete and to Nikki for making this happen in the midst of this, how many times can we say unprecedented, but in this unprecedented pandemic. We're so happy to be here. This is our home, and so the fact that we can be here and not have to feel like we're bereft of being at home is, to me, it's a huge blessing. So I want to thank everybody at St. Luke's, and especially Nikki and Pete for making this happen. I also want to take this moment I want to thank the administration at UCF. They bent over backwards, sideways, forwards, every way you can figure out to make it happen so that we could rehearse. They gave us the ballroom in the student union. They have provided staff support so that we could rehearse. And I don't know what to say. I'm actually kind of having some difficulty right now talking because of how grateful I am to the faculty, to the administration at UCF. So I want to say thank you to Dr. Dykin, our chief medical officer. I want to say thank you to Jeff Moore, of course, the Dean of the College of Arts and Humanities, and to Provost Johnson and to President Cartwright, and of course to Director Michael Weinstein. So thank you very much for giving us the opportunity to rehearse. I wouldn't have survived this semester without being able to make music with these amazing people. So thank you so much.
I would like to add a thank you to everyone who's watching tonight. Good evening, and thank you for tuning in, although in a virtual setting. I have to say Dr. Park put me up to introducing this, so I'm going to try my best to not crash and burn. But I will start tonight by introducing the first piece, the Henry Purcell's Abdelazar Suite. Now, Henry Purcell was an English composer of the Baroque idiom, and he lived a rather short life from 1659 to 1695, although it was a very prolific and productive life. He had a great outpouring of music across different styles and many different sects in society that he composed for, including the church and the court and private affairs. But perhaps his most creative input was that of inventively inducing different national styles, in particular the Italian and French style, into his music. The music you'll hear tonight evokes that of French dance And I do encourage you to get up and move if you feel the desire to. There is no pressure, as no one is watching you. But in addition, I would like to, I think it's important to note that this music was originally incidental music to a play by the same name, by Alpha Ben, I believe. And unfortunately, her play is not as known today as Purcell's score, but I do encourage you to look it up, and maybe the story will give you a greater appreciation for the music. And in conclusion, I would like to note we will be playing all of our selected movements from tonight but completely by memory. And I think that this is a very unique thing. It's been interesting for all of us. And if anything, I think it strengthens our emotional connectivity to the music and to each other. And I think that's really wonderful. There's not much more we can ask for right now. So without further ado, please enjoy Henry Purcell's Abdelazar's Suite.
Thank you. The next piece that we'll be playing is George Frideric Handel's Concerto Grosso in D major. Within these six movements, listen for little solos between each section of the orchestra, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Our third and final piece we'll be performing tonight is the five variants of Divus and Lazarus by Rafe Vaughn Williams. This piece is based on an English folk song of the same name, Divus and Lazarus, that Rafe Vaughn Williams learned as a child and then was able to compose this piece. The piece was commissioned in 1939 for the World's Fair held in New York. And the piece features the theme of the folk song, as well as five variants or variations of the folk song. In the piece, Vaughn Williams also incorporates a couple additional English folk songs, which you may recognize here and there. But the piece was, like I said, premiered in New York in 1939 by Sir Adrian Bolt and the New York Philharmonic. Sir Adrian Bolt also conducted the British premiere in 1939, and Vaughn Williams enjoyed the piece so much that he, one of his final requests was that it be performed at his funeral in Westminster Abbey, where it was also conducted by Sir Adrian Bolt. It is my privilege to conduct this piece tonight in this incredible orchestra, and I hope you enjoy.
Everybody say hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Dad. Say hi to somebody you love. Ready? One, two, three.
Hi, Leslie.